We will see. I mean, that's definitely what Team Portugal wants to see. When we look at Felix Sapronis, it's important to remember he's only 17. He's just a teenager.
There's 20 years difference between these two players. What are the characteristics that you really like about Thiago?
Because
you were playing around the same time as him, right?
That's right. We played in like the World Cadet Challenge. You know, I think many things have changed since then, but he's a very stable player. You know? Those players where can go up and down a lot, can play well, they can play not so well, but he's very stable. And that's very important in a team match. Oh, like, he's a formidable opponent.
True. But you said he looks really good on his forehand.
He looks very good.
Now, a little less nervous energy from Felix LeBron compared to Alexei, who was at these early stages doing laps of honor, almost.
Exactly, just getting out that energy.
But he's just as vocal, and he's just as quick at the table, isn't he?
Yeah, instead of running in circles, I think Felix LeBron likes to run in place.
Yeah.
Bounce in place. But he is the clear favorite here, which is a different feeling than
right.
how Alexei LeBron entered the previous match.
Let's talk about that penhole grip as well that you see from Felix there, because it is so unusual these days, isn't it?
It's very unusual, especially unusual outside of Asia.
Right.
Actually, we're here in Busan, Korea. Koreans very
Some
good.
Some of the best in the world, weren't
exactly,
they?
Exactly. In penhold, because they had the best footwork.
By the way, you just saw how powerful his backhand is there. That's the RPB that we saw
yes.
in action.
Watch this replay. It's so quick, and it creates a special kind of spin. So
that you
different.
Just, you will not have that anywhere else unless you're playing the RPB.
Yes. Unique to RPB.
And I think back in the day, that the backhand was almost non-existent with penholds. Am I right in saying that?
That's right, that's right. You would just block, I think, Nisha Lien's penhold.
You'd almost constantly use that forehand, wouldn't you?
Yes, you try to use the forehand as much as you can and just play defensively on your backhand until the invention of the RPB from the Chinese team, I believe, mid-2000s.
It just looks so awkward, doesn't it? So difficult to do.
It is very difficult. And it was truly an adjustment made to kind of the sponge revolution, the shorter games, the bigger ball. Felix LeBron said he chose this type of playing style because he had a Chinese player actually at his father's club in Montpellier who played with that grip and he wanted to be just like him.
I mean, it's refreshing. It's nice to see a top 10 player in the men's game with that. There you go. There's the backhand we're talking about.
Yeah, very different.
Yeah, seems to be getting into a role. Now, Thiago Apollonio's played 20 previous opponents with penhold grip. He's only beaten five of them.
Were they all from Asia?
You would think so, right? He has struggled. He has really struggled. 25% win rate against penhold grip. It's because you just see it so rarely.
Yes, and the ones who are very good at are like Xuxing.
Right. Yeah, and he's of that Xuxing sort of class, isn't he? That back in the day.
That generation.
That generation, there you go. Four game points here for LeBron. Just too good, LeBron. Oh, it's countered. What a rally! Well, that is the rally of the day so far.
Deserves the standing applause.
Well, credit as well to Apollonia for staying in this.
Thought it was over so many times. Felix just seems so quick. He's winning. The balls are right in the table. He's winning the long rallies. And Thiago Apollonia are just picking up points here and there, but not really in control.
Yeah, I mean, it's a bit of a veteran team, isn't it? Mm-hmm. Portugal, they're going to want to have to bring some new youngsters through, regenerate.
I bet they are pleased to have earned their quota spot at the Olympics.
Yeah. It could be the last hurrah for a number of them. Yeah, this is going well for LeBrun.
I feel like LeBrun is just on fire. Maybe he always plays like that, but it looks especially good today. Almost no unforced errors. Every ball, perfect quality.
One, two. Three.
Yeah, you look at João Geraldo, and he's going to be 30 next year mm-hmm. as well. So yeah, all of them, you know, 30 and above, pretty much.
Right. They earned their quota spot in Paris 2024, and we will likely see a new team
yeah,
for LA 2028.
One. Yeah.
Six, four.
Well, a little bit of a fight back here from Thiago Apollonia.
But it's Felix LeBrun who still has the edge. He's yeah. still in control.
Yeah, I don't think he's able to impose himself yet on this Apollonia, has he? Not yet.
Not yet.
Five.
You know, he's able to seven. Get points like this. He can pick up points like this, but he's not doing it consistently.
Right.
That just came off, I think, the finger of LeBrun.
Felix LeBrun plays with that youthful energy. I mean, he's only 17. He could still be a junior.
Yes, correct.
Many 17-year-olds still playing in the junior ranks, and he's world number six.
Amazing. I mean, I guess in the male game, the men's game, the closest equivalent would have been the sort of a Tomokazu Harimoto. Mm-hmm. It's all action at the moment. But more often than not, it's LeBrun who's winning.
Just keeps going every shot at full quality. And it's LeBrun who changed the direction.
Yeah.
And that shows he's in control.
There's a phone ringing somewhere.
Nine. Six. Seven. Nine.
Just took the edge there, Apollonia.
The fight in Felix LeBrun is incredible. He never seems nervous.
Seven.
No, he doesn't. Ten. You're right.
Mm-hmm.
It's a LeBrun trait, isn't it? Of just not looking fazed by much. Three game points now for LeBrun to go two up here.
10, 8.
Just taking the edge himself. Two game points. Serving for this game and maybe to go three up and win, make it one all.
One. Four.
What does Apolloni need to do for you here to try and arrest this progress of LeBron?
Just needs to kind of stop LeBron from just ripping things from both sides. You can see LeBron so quick. One.
It's not like the backhand is any weaker.
Exactly. And actually, Apolloni is going into the backhand. If it's not any weaker, there's almost nowhere to go for him. See Apolloni play more shots like that. Serve short and just try to finish it.
Yeah.
When he goes into these big rallies, Felix is just faster. And we saw Felix there serving long to get into this rally. I mean, Felix just wants to go at you. It's interesting to think because that's typically a junior style almost. Serve long and just go bang, 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 bang.
Yeah, that's a disappointing serve there from LeBron.
Feel that Felix LeBron has more shots than Apolloni. He's just faster and has more shots.
The array of shots are there. He did well. That was going to be put away. Just clutching his side there.
Oh, interesting.
And a timeout called. Was that by France? Yeah, he's just jabbed it into the table, isn't he? On that last shot.
Important point coming out of the timeout. Build your own momentum again. It's an interesting choice by Apolloni. Very simple serves.
Another great rally.
It's just that Felix LeBron, I think, has more shots. Felix LeBron here, backhand, forehand, just keeps going.
That backhand is so impressive. 6 out of 8 still have gone LeBron's way.
Left, 8, 4. 8, 5.
Shaking it off there. That's one I know he thinks he should have put away.
5, 9. Six, 9.
It almost feels like we're just going through the motions. I think Felix LeBron has this in the bag, although it's commentator's curse.
Yeah.
Who's looking very good.
9.
Even that one gets beyond.
8.
LeBrun, only 1 point in it.
Great angle.
Now it's France who are taking the timeout.
Respect.
Couple of amazing forehands there from Apollonia.
Wow. It's like he really came alive. It was commentator's curse.
A solitary match point here for Felix LeBrun. So LeBrun wins it. Excellent play from him throughout.